ages, yet she represented our state with dignity and grace. My, how things have changed. In the few weeks after we lost Governor Haley to become Ambassador Haley, governor that we have now filling in raised our taxes, the largest tax increase in modern history is what it's being called, and I'm not even talking about gas tax. Endangered our children by vetoing money to fix our school buses that are bursting into flames every other month and endangering our children. And the thing that I believe to be the most egregious, do y'all know that the Teamsters organized on the Port of Charleston about a month ago without a whimper from Columbia? South Carolina is the most conservative state in the nation. We have Republicans hold the governor's office, the House, the Senate. We control everything. We should be leading this state into a conservative revolution, a bold example of what conservative leadership can do. If the point was to raise taxes and to grow government and to mortgage our future with money we don't have, why not just put the Democrats back in charge? If I thought that Henry McMaster would lead us into a bold conservative revolution, I would be his biggest cheerleader. But he's not. So that's why I'm running for governor. You know, I've never done this before. I've never run before. And someone said, you know, people want to know everything about you when you start running for office. It's kind of amazing. Somebody said, tell us what's in your purse. Well, the women in the room know that I immediately went home and cleaned my purse out. But there are certain things that are always in there. Usually I have a Chick-fil-A coupon of some sort, if I've used the calendar one or whatever it may be. But hope to have my keys. Always have a permission slip that one of my children has forgotten. And I carry my 38 that my granddaddy gave me. And there's more on that story in a minute. But what you really need to know about me, what is most important and defines me the most, is that I'm a mother and a wife. Family is the most important thing to me. The future of South Carolina and its opportunities for my three children and for yours are what's most important to me. And while I have three beautiful children today, Khaki, Hampton, and McCabe, when I was pregnant with the twins, the doctor called my husband Morgan and I in and said, you know, we think we need to run some more tests because we may need to abort one of the twins to save the life of the other. Morgan and I didn't need to run any more tests. We knew that our children were God's children to protect as long as he would allow us. And so that is why family is most important to me. You know, I've been in South Carolina my whole life. My family's 8th generation South Carolina. And there's one thing I can tell you about my family and South Carolina. Whether you've been here forever or you've had the good sense to choose this as your home, we are a defiantly independent people. We don't need the government to tell us what to do. We never have. We know in South Carolina, if you work hard, if you do the right thing, it doesn't matter where you come from, you can achieve absolutely anything. I know it because I watched my dad do it. And it's great that Rusty DePass is here today because he can ground truth my story. My dad grew up with nothing. Rusty grew up down the street. In fact, my aunts and my uncle, come on in. My aunts and my uncle actually slept in a chest of drawers because they couldn't afford a crib. When my parents got married, they lived in public housing. They lived over here in Henley Homes because they couldn't afford anywhere else. But they worked. Every day they worked to give my brother and I opportunities that they didn't have. And because we live in South Carolina, they were able to do just that. That's why I'm running. I want to make sure that my children have the opportunities that I had. And right now in Columbia, they're killing our opportunities. You know, when Governor Haley asked me to join her, I didn't know whether or not I could do anything about government. And she didn't recruit me because I had a long history of fighting unions. She recruited me because I had a long history of beating unions. And that's exactly what I did as your labor secretary. Do y'all remember when Boeing said they were coming and they were going to bring thousands of jobs? And do you remember what happened after that? In an unprecedented move, I believe, President Obama said we couldn't have the jobs.
The unions in Washington State said you couldn't have the jobs. Well, we were not about to let union bosses from out of state come into our state and take our jobs and our money from our families. Amen. We wouldn't let it happen. We wouldn't back down. They thought they could intimidate us. They brought congressional hearings. The media hit us. The AFL-CIO sued me personally. And if you don't think I have a patient and understanding husband, I stayed the course. He supported me to stay the course. What's worse than thinking they could stop us is they thought they could intimidate the workers in South Carolina. But what happened? We didn't back down. We fought, and we kept jobs here, and now they've grown. Now, no good deed goes unpunished. You've heard that before. Everybody in this room, you put the willing horse, and we got a lot of willing horses in this room. Governor Haley asked me to turn that fight on the establishment. She asked me to go take on what we all hate about government. The big, bureaucratic, bossy, bloated government agency, DHEC. Well, we went in, and in the time I served Governor Haley, we helped one in every four entrenched bureaucrat into the private sector, not from the taxpayer roll. That never happened. We actually shrunk government. We saved $68 million in another agency in just 18 months. Well, the liberals lost their minds. We were actually showing people what bold conservative leadership could get done. We also improved the services, so it wasn't just a cut. The liberal media called me a buzzsaw, which I took as a compliment. The Democrats called me dangerous. And then they proceeded to have one of the longest filibusters that any of us could remember to try to stop me. But it was just getting started. Because when the Democrats in this state were hitting me, the Obama administration was abusing South Carolina. The Obama EPA and DOE came in and they were trying to put their nose where it didn't belong. When, it won't be any surprise that I didn't have a lot of love for President Obama, and I think the feeling was mutual. But when I threatened the administration, the New York Times was so incensed that anyone would have the nerve to hold the federal government accountable, they called it a fierce battle, a showdown. They said that South Carolina was threatening Washington. That's exactly what we were doing. And I'm proud of it. I'm proud of the 4 years that I spent working for Governor Haley. I came here to serve you, not to make friends. And we shrunk government. We deregulated. We saved money. We improved services, and we went 3 for 3 with the Obama administration. Now, you can't do all that without stepping on a few toes. So back to the gun in reverse. When I was working for the government, the corrupt establishment got so angry at me that SLED told me I needed to start carrying a weapon. Can you imagine being a civilian and having to carry a gun because you're doing the right thing? Well, they didn't stop me then, and I still carry that gun today because I'm not finished doing the right thing. We have to have people in Columbia who are still rattling cages. Nobody's doing that right now. The Governor Haley and I took on all of this corrupt establishment, and they're all back in their smoke-filled rooms. We have to have leaders who have bold ideas, not establishment politicians. We need conservative leadership, not the status quo. I'm ready to go do that.